Amardeep, you are a change agent. You run an organization that helps companies transform themselves. So, what exactly do you do?
You know, as you said, I'm a change agent. So, whenever an individual or an organization is looking to bring about some significant changes in their life or in the way they run themselves, in the way they manage themselves, and in the way they set priorities for themselves. At the point where you're ready to take on outrageous goals, it means you have the arsenal required for the first step of the change. You have a calling, you have a desire to do something great, to go beyond your comfort zone. And that's the point where a person like me comes in as a coach or as a consultant and helps to get you from point A to point B to point C.
So let's talk about individuals. A lot of people want to get better. They want to transform themselves. They want to transform the organization. How can people go about doing that? Do you have certain methods on how people can do that?
Of course. See, the first step is to identify the areas in which you need transformation in your life. Now, for an individual, those areas could be health and fitness. It could be, I might not be happy with my level of productivity. Or there might be something about my business that I want to change or alter. So once I've identified the areas where I need transformation, my first step is complete. The second step is to spell out what your vision of an ideal situation or ideal life would be. So where is it that you want to go? You know, today you're here and you want to transform yourself. But what is it that you want to become? You have to start picturizing yourself doing that. That's the second step. The next step is to, you know, is self-belief, which is not a step. I'd say it's part of the whole game. So you have to believe that you can do it. You're capable of doing it. And then you just have to go out there and do it. What is also important is that you refocus your goals. And we learn in our organizations day to day that our goals need to be smart. They need to be specific, measurable, achievable, realistic or recordable, and time-bound. Does that mean that you can't set audacious goals? Of course not. As long as you know that you can go out there and achieve those goals, that's all that matters. And then it's a step-by-step process of moving past your challenges onto the journey.
You know, everybody has good intentions, Amar. They set a goal, they want to get better, but they always lose track after a period of time. Good ideas kind of peter out. How do people sustain their goal and actually achieve it?
That's a very good question and a very tricky one also. So I'd again go back to saying that, you know, the first step is to believe that you can do it. That self-belief is very important, and that self-belief is what will carry you through towards your end objective. Apart from that, you know, we use a term in our organization, which is sort of our tagline, that manifesting energy. But we don't manifest energy for anybody else. It's those people who want to transform themselves who manifest the energy that they need to bring about the change in their life. So that's the second most important step. The third step is to identify the things, the habits, and the patterns that are holding you back from moving closer to your goals. If you've been able to, if you're able to do that, that's half the battle already won. Because you'll be conscious that this thing affects my end objective or my goal. And you'll try and avoid it as far as possible. Now, apart from that, it always helps to plan. So if I'm wanting to bring about or do anything substantial, I need to have a plan for myself. So you can have some daily objectives, some monthly or quarterly objectives, and of course your annual or maybe couple of years that the plan is for. It's important that every time you achieve those milestones, you also reward yourself. And that reward is what carries you through. So it is that whole, you know, rewarding myself and feeling that little small sense of accomplishment after having done something that sees you through the journey.
So you told me this interesting story about how a year back you used to weigh over 100 kgs. At one point in time you were 120 kgs.
Yes.
Look at you now. I mean, look at you.
Stand up.
That's, how did you make that transformation of losing weight?
Stand up.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this guy at one point in time used to weigh 120 kgs about a year back. So tell us that story, Amar.
So on 1st of January 2014, I was 108 kgs. My journey had started long before. And all through the year, I've been working out, morning and evening. I've taken time out, I've gone to work. Before work and after work, I've been working out. I've eaten right, I've made the right decisions when it came to my lifestyle choices. I've slept the right required number of hours. I saw success, and I used the same approach I did in all my working life. So it's that same approach that I use towards my work, which I brought to my own personal life, that really made the difference and made the impact. The same SMART goals that I talked to you about is the same philosophy that worked here. Social media communities help a lot. I never quite hit the gym.
Really?
That's something I never did. I did organic workouts. I played sports, ran, jogged, swam, anything and everything all through the year. And I could do all of this because I had identified some patterns in my own lifestyle which were holding me back. I had a mirror most of the times in the room in which I used to work out. So in that mirror I could see, you know, parts of me that were probably larger than life and the one I need to focus on. And I had my share of setbacks. About midway through the year, I fractured my wrist, and I see there's something wrong with your wrist. You got a fracture as well.
Yes.
So I fractured my wrist, and if you look, I still can't get my hand, you know,
straight.
to come straight. Mm. And I was on a biking trip to Leh. While coming back on the last day, I had a severe accident. My wrist got fractured. I had stitches on my face. I have a scar here, and my whole leg was bruised. Now this was a time I could either give up on my whole exercise routine.
It's a perfect excuse, right?
And I was, I was 85 then, which is okay from, you know, 120 I started, 108 at the beginning of the year, 85. The perfect time for me to stop and say, I need a break.
Or you've achieved it.
Or I've achieved it. But I switched to yoga, I did push-ups, I did all I could. I couldn't work out with that intensity because I had a fractured wrist. But I continued persevering towards my goal.
How much do you weigh now?
68.
Wow.
So it's been quite a journey, and obviously it comes with its own share of.
But Amma, what I like is that, I mean, you apply the same principles. I mean, you're walking the talk, right? You help other businesses and people transform themselves, and you really proved it yourself. Now, a transformation coach or a change agent, we all know what the rough explanation
let's sit down.
Yeah, why don't you sit down? So we all know what the meaning is and all that. But a couple of things. What do you do, or what do people like transformation coaches do? How do you impact people, and how can people make the most of what you have to offer?
You know, I'll start by saying that life coaching as a subject is not without its share of you know, doubts that people have in their minds. It's something which is very new in India. We've all heard of CEO coaches, and I worked with some of them as well. You know, the thing you've got to understand is that the relationship between a coach is very different from a consultant or a mentor or any such other similar relationship. If you look at athletes, for example, you know, they know what they're there for. They know what they're training for, but they need a coach to guide them, to see them through, to help them identify patterns with their style, their stance, which may or may not be visible to them, because they're walking the talk themselves. You know, they're playing a sport. Similarly, same is the case with individuals. In our lives, there are certain patterns that hold us back, and at times it's not easy enough to identify those patterns by ourselves. So that's one value add that a coach does. The other is that, you know, the daunting problems that you have as an individual or as a business owner or in your personal life, they may be really daunting for you, but for an outsider who's got an outside view, the solution is sometimes very simple. So if you, in a nutshell, a coach will assist you with your personal development. They'll assist you with setting goals. They'll act like your mirror and hold you accountable for those goals. And the relationship I share with my clients were, you know, I can't even call them clients. They're my friends. And I have a relationship with them for life because I've helped them with their business. I've helped them with their lives. And I can't say that, you know, that it's been rewarding for them. More than that, I think it's been rewarding for me. You know, it's a very good feeling being a coach at the end of it. It's something I'm very passionate about. And I'm able to act as their mirror, or you can say be an extension of their inner voice, help them come up with better reasoning, and help them move towards growth. You know, it's also a coaching relationship has to start at an opportune time. You can't just decide today that I want to go and hire a coach or I need a coach to help me out with this. It doesn't work like that. Any coach who's authentic will tell you that we don't work with just anyone and everyone. So we need to be convinced, and the person who's coming to us needs to be convinced with an idea of what they want to do or achieve or accomplish. And you know, if they're probably having a hard time getting it done, that's the right time to look for a coach. Which means that, like I said before, there's already a willingness to change, and you possess that spark in you. Now, to ignite that spark and manifest the energy that you need to accomplish your goals, that's what coaching is all about.
Awesome. Amardeep, thank you so much, and really, really enjoyed this conversation.
It is my pleasure, and I'm glad that you were able to find time to have this meeting.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.